Hello, welcome to 1 year on of Can an Electric Car Swim? Can you submerge an electric car battery and motor underwater without being damaged? And I will find out the hard way so you don't have to. Let's have a recap on what this video is about. Now, if you don't know and you haven't seen the video, you can look at it top right. But we'll do a quick recap and we'll tell you what this whole video is about. About a year and a couple of months ago, we had a lot of rain around here in Derbyshire. A lot of rain. There was a very famous dam that almost broke its books around here. And my wife had a car parked near a brook stream that burst its banks. And this little car went for a little bath. I then went to go and pick my wife's car up, little float as she calls it, the Zoe. We went to go and pick it up from this area where it had a little bath. It didn't get very high, just about halfway up the alloy wheel, but there was a little bit of water inside and things did get a little bit wet. So the first thing I did was contact my friend, who is an EV mechanic. He works for a large manufacturer, and I said, can I drive the car or is it broke? And he said, just go in the car, turn it on. If there's any fault in the car will detect faults of the contactors and won't let it start. I started it, no error showed on the dash, and I drove it all the way to work. And then I gave it a full strip down. I took the seats out, I took the interior out, I let a humidifier sit in the car for several days to soak any last moisture out. Now, it didn't get anywhere near the 12-volt system, but as a bolt and brace measure, I cleaned all the 12-volt contactors out with contact spray. I even did extra stuff. Now, even though I checked the water line and I could physically see the water line on the wheel and I could physically see the water line on the side of the car and wherever the water line got inside the car, I still wanted to have a bolt and brace measures that none of that water got into the motor, transmission box, whatever you want to call it, where the Zoe is here. And there's a little capping in there that you can take off. And I got specifically told if any water got in there, fluid would pour out. I'd know if anything extra got in there, because when you open that cap, nothing should come out. It should be completely and utterly run free. Opened it up, nothing came out. But what I did do as a precaution, I took a dip test of it and sent it off to a lab for making sure that it was all right, and that it was free from moisture, and also to see if it was due for a change. Nothing wrong with it, so I left it alone, put the cap on, and it, you know, that's it. That was my bolt and braces measure for checking that. Everything else is sealed and everything else was a lot higher up than that lowest failure point there. Now, when I posted this video originally, let's just say I have some internet trolls. They know exactly who they are and they're not very nice people. They tend to be kicked out of most EV forums all over the internet, and one or two EV forums, they still lurk, but everyone knows who they are. If you're on an EV forum, which is web-based forum, or even on a Facebook forum, you'll know exactly who these people are, and one of them in particular doesn't like me very much. And as soon as I posted this video, he said, Nick's going to be selling that car within the next 2 months. Get ready to see that car for sale. Well, I've still got the car. It's a year and 4 months since it happened, and my wife has put over 7,500 miles on that car since. And the only thing that's gone wrong on the Zoe in that entire time is a snap spring, which on a 2015 plate Zoe is literally the most common item in the world. So completely an unrelated spring snap that had nothing to do with its little bath. But this is the internet, and internet trolls love to always deny and think that they know better. Obviously, I work in a garage. I work as a garage. I have a workshop. I have a mechanic. I have friends in the EV industry that know what they're doing. I also am very good friends with a Renault dealer. So obviously I've used all these facilities to the best of my knowledge to check, double check and cross check that everything on this car is completely fine. I've then also ran it for 12 months and put 7,000 miles on. I've drained the battery completely to zero. I've charged the battery up to completely 100%. And there is zero faults. But that will not let them rest. They still are determined to find fault. And that's where the joke from the start of the video comes from, which is that the car's gonna smell and it's gonna have a damp smell. Now, they completely ignored that I used an industrial humidifier in the car for several days. There was no moisture in this car. There was zilch, not even a drop of moisture left. But they will continue to say that, and they can continue to say it all they want. If you want to personally come and stick your nose in my wife's car, Mr. Troll, give me a ring, come up. You can sniff any of the carpets all you want. There is zilch wrong with this car. And that is a testament to two things. One, how reliable Renaults are. And number two, how brilliant electric drivetrains are. However, it's been a year, so it's time to do some maintenance to my Renault Zoe. This Zoe, as I said, is a 2015 1.5 plate car, and it is still on its original Renault battery. It wasn't changed at the 3 year interval. The only thing I've changed on this car is the brake fluid and had the regular Renault services, but I have completely ignored Renault's recommendation on changing that battery at 3 years, and it is now over 5 years old and it hasn't failed. So if you look after your 12 volt battery in the manner you're supposed to, it'll be fine. Now, during lockdown, they did have the check electrical fault thing on because it wasn't being used. It didn't get used for like 2-3 weeks at a time. So all I did was kept opening and shutting the door and then took it for a little bit of a run, and the battery's been fine since. It's not acted up since lockdown finished several weeks ago, months ago. God, I can't even remember. Everything's a blur during COVID now, isn't it? But that's all done. But there's some maintenance that I need to do, and there's some maintenance I need to tell you to do, because it's quite a common fault on Zoes, and that is the scuttle drains, which are under here, get blocked, and you can actually get water inside your Zoe. Now, water inside your Zoe can be bad, because if it fills up in here, it gets in that fuse holder, and that is the one place you don't want any water. Right, so let's get this trim off, let's get it cleaned up, and let's show you how to clean out the scuttle drains. So once you get the rubbers out, lay them out in the method they came out on, and you've got some little clips here that need to be coming out, so you're going to need a wedge to get underneath them and pop them off. Yeah, these are the wrong tools, but our mechanic's off for the day, so this is what I've got because I can't get in the workshop. Okay, so I've got this off. When you took the wipers off, you've took these two clips out. You just give it a good pull and these clips should come out. They don't break usually, they're usually pretty easy to get off, but if you're worried that you're going to break them, then order some spare ones off Renault, or ask Renault to clean the scuttle drains out when you have the car serviced. I mean, let's be honest, they don't really do much for the service they do. But once you've got this off, the scuttle drains are down here and you can feel them if you put your hand right down here, and you'll be able to feel where they are. Just get some water down there and get them cleaned out, and you'll, there you go. So there's plenty of muck inside there. Just give them a wash out, get a kettle, get some water down, and just clean them out, because if this area fills up with water in here, it will leak inside the car. You'll get wet footwells, you'll get wet fuse departments. It will cause serious electrical faults for your car. So get this off, give it a clean. I recommend at least once a year to get this cleaned out, and then once you've got it all cleaned out, clip it all back on, put the wipers back on, and fix it all up, and you'll be fine for another 12 months. 12 months is a bit over the top. You might be able to get away with every 2 years, but the reason I say every 12 months, if you live near any trees and any leaves get in here and gets it filled up, for the time it'll take you just to do this general regular maintenance, it'll save you a lot of aggro. Now, it's a good job I did check my scuttle drain, because this side has loads of water in it and the scuttle drain is blocked and it's starting to fill up. So it's a good job I did this preventive maintenance, and you should probably go and check yours as well, because the driver's side is the worst side for it to happen on, because that's where your main fuse for the whole traction battery is. Now, I had to remove this extra panel to get to it because the window wipers are in the way, and I can feel it's full of rubbish, and I mean full of rubbish. So I'm gonna get that cleared out, get some sort of stuff in there to get it cleared out, and then flush it clean just to make sure it's all nice and clean. But you can, you know, there's just so much rubbish in there. Thank you very much for watching this week's video. Hope you've enjoyed it. Don't forget to like and share my channel. Check out my other videos. And if you wanna support my channel, check out Patreon. You can even pay in English pounds now. Thank you very much for watching this week's video. Goodbye.